Hello everyone, this is the second part of my tutorial on how to paint a 72nd scale figure. And like I mentioned in the first part, we're going by body part, and right now we're up to the head of the figure, in this case the hat. And I'm using a nice tan color to paint the hat. One thing I learned about another pro builder, he told me, when you're building or painting something, don't be so perfect about it at first. You be perfect and you fix everything after you have everything put together. But at first, it will take you less time to fix everything and make everything look perfect after it's put together, rather than just perfectionizing piece by piece from the beginning. And I've tested out myself, and it's true. You know, you might feel a little weird. You know, it also depends on how you're used to painting or building. I honestly feel that just basically have like some type of freehand technique going on, so that it can make it easier for you to produce faster and more. So here we have the hat. Let that dry a little bit. Now we're gonna go back to the shirt. Just touch it up. Touch it up on the green. Another thing I don't want to forget to mention is, when you're painting a figure and you're dipping the brush in the paint, you want to consider only dipping the tip of the brush. I don't know if you can see that little colored tip of the brush there. Simply because by dipping the entire brush into the paint, it would just cause you to have an unwanted mess, and also you're going to waste paint. And believe it or not, one drop of paint will make a difference in the future. Because when you look at your paint and your the amount of supplies you have, because of those little careless mistakes that you make, it's simply because you didn't realize that you was wasting material, because you didn't know how to control or basically maneuver the way you use those materials. So it's best if you just dip the tip of the brush in either the paint or the Elmer's glue, if you're priming your figures with Elmer's glue, or just keep it simple, little drops, little dots. You know, just think about it. These are small figures. They don't require too much paint. Just few dots will fill in the blanks and you should be good to go. Moving on here, the shirt looks like it's good. Now we're just gonna fill in the blanks on the overlap colors that the pants have. So to better say, we're gonna clarify those little mistakes that the pants have while we were painting the shirt. So the shirt is done. Let's clean that brush now. Go back to our brown. I felt the liberty to play some music in the background for you guys. I personally find it very relaxing and inspiring. Something that many artists couldn't relate to. Music and art, something that go along together, and I like combining both because it helps me focus better in the middle of the craziness. So here we are. We have the two biggest parts already painted. Now we're going to focus on the smaller parts of the figure, which are the shoes, the arm, the hands, the face, and the rabbits that this guy is carrying here. Also the gun. Okay. Let's put this down. Just give one little simple coating on the hat. There you go. It's good to go. Let's put this down. Now we're going to go with the hands. And for this part, I'm going to use a skin tone. At this point, you want to be a little bit more careful how you paint, because you're getting further into smaller details and you don't want to keep going back and forth to the parts that are already painted just simply because you messed up or overlap with another color. So at this point, like I mentioned before, you want to become a little bit more careful and control your brush a little bit more. The hands. With painting 72nd scale figures, I found that it was easier to just sacrifice a little bit of the gun or whatever accessory the figure is holding, and then just clean it up once you're done with the hands or the skin tone that you want to add to your figure. So here we have the hands already made. Now we're going to focus on the face. This guy has a beard, so what we want to do is just sacrifice the beard just paint, cover the face with the skin tone. Paint the neck here. Keeping the brush closer to the beard, away from the shirt. Trying not to go back to the shirt. If you do, it's okay. On the next part of this video, I will be focusing on the smaller details. So stick around.